means it's time for a creature feature. So every week we show off some awesome animals that you can check out from our friends here at the Shell Factory. Jason's with us along with...
A diamond dove.
A diamond dove.
Jen.
Yes.
So this is Neil. He's a diamond dove.
And he's like Neil Diamond?
Like Neil Diamond. Yeah. I like that.
I dig it.
And he's actually full grown. Everybody thinks he's a little baby, but this is probably one of the smallest species of doves there is.
What did he look like as a wee little one?
Probably like a little jelly bean.
Really?
A little pink jelly bean. That's amazing. Where are they from?
So they're native to Australia, pretty much all over Australia.
Wow.
And they're pretty common pets. Not normally do they particularly care to be handled.
Mm-hmm.
They're more like aviary birds. You have a big enclosure, something relaxing to look at and listen to.
Sure, more canary-like than okay.
Do they, are they vocal?
Yeah, they'll do a cooing like a pigeon or a dove, and the males will bow up and down, and they fan their tail out like a peacock.
Oh, cool. I love the orange around the eyes, too. I mean, it's really pretty.
So this one is so they wean, and they're fully independent at 2 weeks old.
Mm. Wow.
This guy's probably about a month old.
That's...
So he's going to get a lot darker, almost like a slate blue color.
Mm-hmm.
And then he'll actually see the white spots on his wings that look like diamonds.
Wow.
Sweet looking, though.
Really cool. What does he eat? That's a sharp, very pointed beak.
Right. He couldn't hurt you, so he's going to eat finch seed or parakeet seed.
Mm-hmm. And in the wild, what would he eat?
All kinds of, they're on the ground a lot, so different seeds, grains, things like that. Maybe a couple small bugs.
No, he was somebody's pet? Is that how?
So we got, I think we got about 16 of them for our one aviary that the guests can walk into.
Oh, cool.
So this one, for whatever reason, even before I clipped his wings, he could not fly.
Aww.
So he's actually in a cage with the one that's only about 2 weeks old now.
Mm-hmm.
They're just going to stay together.
So how long does it take for their wings to recover, I guess you would say, from a clipping?
Maybe like a bird this size, a couple months. Yeah. They'll molt, and then the new feathers will grow back in.
Will he be able to fly once that happens, or is it more or less?
Probably not, because he was fully flighted when we got him, and he just couldn't fly.
Interesting.
Didn't see any injuries or anything.
And people hear about clipping wings. Can you explain what that is and why that's done sometimes?
So it's basically like a haircut.
Mm-hmm.
It does not hurt the bird. You know, the bird is probably going to be not happy about it, but birds, they're very dramatic, so they're going to be screaming and trying to bite.
Right.
But it's literally, they don't feel anything. And they will grow back. The larger parrots, it can take up to a year for them to fully molt and for their flight feathers to regrow, but they will grow back.
Hmm. And basically just cutting the tail and like the two flight feathers or one wing so that they can't take off or they can't hurt themselves, basically.
And they still, it's not like they're going to drop right to the ground. Mm. They're going to slowly kind of glide down to the ground. And it's just for their safety because a lot of them, even with clipped wings, a good breeze can still blow your bird away.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of times you don't get them back, unfortunately.
Oh, that's too bad.
I know you guys have a lot coming up at the Shell Factory.
We have Golden Fest, we have Nam Jam, we have the NFL Sunday Ticket every Sunday at Tommy's Bar outside. There's some great beer and wing combo specials. And then I know it's a little early, but it's coming up Christmas.
Yeah.
So we're going to have Santa there in July and Breakfast with Santa again.
Oh, my gosh.
Nice.
All kinds of good things happen at the Shell Factory. Well, thank you for being here.
Sure.
And Neil, you were so good.
Thank you, Neil.
Yeah, it's very sweet Caroline, right? We'll put a link to the Shell Factory's website on ours, which is abc-7.com. We'll be right back with more in the morning.